Looks like you're on the wrong side of the bars this time.
I'm all right.
And she'll stay that way just so long as you don't try anything.
I didn't know what had happened when I walked in last night.
I know you couldn't have.
Don't shut me out, Mom.
I'm sorry. I just feel so empty.
Mrs. Jackson, we're really sorry about Bill.
Not half as sorry as you're going to be. Now you listen to me. I want the name of the woman who killed my husband.
It was me. I killed your husband.
You say when you first picked up the scissors, you had no intention of stabbing Bill Jackson.
That's right.
Well, what did you intend to do with them?
I meant to stab her.
What made you change your mind?
It wouldn't have done any good. They found out who stabbed your father. Well, don't you want to know who did it?
I wouldn't know her. The name wouldn't mean anything to me. It was just one of the prisoners.
Yes. Yes, they're all the same to you. Well, we can go ahead with the funeral arrangements now.
The others could have come.
Someone had to work. I think it's time we were going.
Yes. I'm really sorry, Meg. We're all going to miss him.
Yes, but...
Meg, I have been watching you after the last few days, and if you carry on the way you're going to end up with a nervous breakdown.
That isn't why you want me to resign here, because I remind you of the mess you caused by allowing B. Smith in with the others when she should have been in solitary. Well, I'm not going. I'm not going to make it easy for you. And if you sack me, I'll tell the whole world why.
Meg!
Oh, no.
What is it?
It's my son, Marty. He's gone, left home. Well, I knew he wasn't happy, but to just go off without discussing it.
Oh, why discuss it? He sounds pretty confident there. Is that for real or is he faking it?
Oh, no. He can look after himself.
Well, he's a smart kid, or so you say, and he's taken off. Look, I know this isn't going to be very much comfort, but these things happen all the time. He could be back tomorrow. They sometimes are. Or maybe in a couple of months.
Oh, don't give me your statistics. I'm going to phone the police.
I wouldn't do that. You don't want him back here being held by the scruff of the neck, do you? Assuming that the police find him.
Well, what am I supposed to do?
Calm down.
Allow me, Lady Cuthbert.
Thank you, Lord Pontwhistle.
Oh, it was a smashing play, though, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was good. And I love the costumes.
Jean's still not home?
No, it doesn't look like it. Hey, do you like a cup of coffee?
Oh, yes, please. Have you seen much of Steve lately?
Me?
I mean, has he been calling in on Jean a lot?
Well, I'm not sure. Hey, I do have my own life to lead, you know.
Yes, of course.
And as she'll be leaving soon, I don't suppose either you or Steve will be seeing that much of her.
No. Not that I probably would have got too involved with her. Bit flighty, isn't you?
Oh, I don't know.
Yes, you do, but you're too loyal to say so. You're a good friend, Meg.
Thanks.
Look, I don't think I'll have that coffee. I'm a bit tired. I think I'll be pushing off.
Oh, all right then.
Thanks for coming with me.
Oh, thank you for a lovely evening.
Good night.
Goodbye.
Look, I'll be all right.
You are not all right, and you'll stay here until I say you are all right.
Oh, it's just a bump on the head. Now, don't be ridiculous, Grig. A couple of aspirins and I'll be fine.
You were unconscious for at least 5 minutes. Now, you'll lay there quietly until I see if there's any sign of concussion.
Will you need me for anything?
No, thanks, Vera.
It was all my own fault, Vera. I tried to break it up. I just got in the way. They didn't do it deliberately.
That was stupid. Why didn't you call another officer?
Reflex action.
I'll check in on you later.
What was that about?
Vera was saying the other day when she got that woman away from the gunman, it was just a reflex action. I just don't make as good a heroine as she does.
Do you know, I think that's the first time I've ever seen Vera laugh.
Ah, she's not so bad. She just needs people. I guess we all do.
Oh, that's all I needed. Oh, I feel a weak-kneed idiot.
No, you're not. Look, I don't think you should be left alone tonight.
No, I don't think so either.
I might go now, if you don't mind.
To work? Early, isn't it?
Yes, we'll give you a chance to get ready. See you later, then.
Bye.
Bye.
Let's be honest with each other. Nothing could come of us having an affair.
Why not?
Well, I'm 10 years older than you for a start.
So?
We have absolutely nothing in common but our work.
Well, we'd find that out, wouldn't we? Look, Meg, you're lonely. You've admitted that. Well, my private life isn't exactly a great social whirl. So what is wrong with two lonely people getting together occasionally and... If it leads to other things, well, what's the harm?
Loneliness isn't a good basis for a relationship, you know that. Look what happened to Vera.
Look, I'm not saying it's ideal, but it's a start, isn't it?
It's a start.
Well, say yes.
I don't know.
Friends? Can I come around tonight?
Hey, Doc!
Lizzie, how many times do I have to tell you to knock?
Oh, sorry, Mrs. Jackson. You know, Bea told us there was something going on between you, but we thought she was pulling our leg.
There's nothing going on.
Oh, you can trust me, Doc. I won't open me mouth.
What do you want, Lizzie?
Oh, I forgot.
Don't read into a situation which isn't there, Lizzie.
Oh, me? Never. Oh, Mrs. Jackson, you forgot. Get I was even here. I never seen a thing.
Meg, you know what this place is like for gossip. Mostly, you can ignore it.
That's the best thing to do with it, isn't it?
But every now and again, something comes up which you can't ignore. Please understand, this is more than a little embarrassing, but there has been a lot of talk about you and Greg. Is there any truth in it?
Well, suppose there is. What of it? Has my private life suddenly become subject to departmental regulations?
Meg, please, of course not. I'm not talking to you officially. I'm talking to you as a friend. I'm concerned about you.
I realize that, Erica.
I can't help feeling it would be better if you became involved with someone outside this place. I know what a big part the prisoners played in your life and in Bill's.
Erica! Now, Bill's dead, and I'm learning to live without him.
That's why I don't want you to make any mistakes.
Look, I give enough of my time to this place during working hours. Do you think you're entitled to interfere in what I do when I'm off duty?
I'm sorry, Meg, I was
only
trying to
help. What I do in my own time is my own business. And what, if anything, I do in my own bed is most certainly my own business. So please, Erica, I would appreciate it if we could just drop the whole subject.
Yeah.
Where's Lizzie?
Well, she has come down with an attack of chronic imaginitis. She's down with your friend, the doc, getting a cure for the Black Death or whatever it is she's got this time.
I reckon Lizzie's got the hots for Dr. Miller. That's what's wrong with her.
You want to watch it, Mrs. Jackson. Now Lizzie'll be cutting you out.
There's nothing for me to watch out for, and you can stop all that sniggering.
Oh, come on. Just a bit of fun.
Just get on with your work. The lot of you. In fact, we've become quite a source of entertainment for
them. To hell with the women. You know what they're like. They gossip about anything.
Oh, it's not just them. It's the staff. Even Erica are apparently intrigued and concerned about our relationship.
Well, to hell with them too, and Erica. What we do outside the prison walls is our business and no one else's.
Well, don't you think I know that? Don't you think I've actually said it? Well, you may be able to shrug it off, but for me it's not quite so easy.
It really is getting to you, isn't it? Look, I think maybe you should consider leaving Wentworth. Doctor's orders.
Well, thanks for the concern. But I'm not exactly a girl any longer, Greg. And what if I did leave Wentworth? What would I be expected to do after all these years? I've got to make a living somehow. And I'm a little too old to make a career out of being a kept woman.
What are you doing?
Well, you said you were hungry.
Well, I am, but so let's go out and eat. Now, Mr. Campbell and Mr. Hines are all
very
well.
No, I don't want to. I'm not in the mood. I don't want people staring at us and saying, look at that nice young man taking his mother out for a treat.
That's pathetic. I really do hope you enjoy yourself when you go on like this.
Well, I don't. I don't enjoy myself at all. Oh, I'm sick of being discreet when everyone knows anyway. I'm sick of wondering what the hell you see in me. I'm sick of worrying about someone younger and smarter coming along and... You're no use. You can't even tell me a few lies to cheer me up. You don't even want to think about it, do you?
Doesn't seem to be doing you much good.
Look. I was married to Bill for 17 years. I didn't run around having affairs. I mean, there were one or two blokes before I was married, but I've forgotten what it was like to just... Oh. I guess I'm not very cool. But my emotions just all get tangled up and, well, that's what I am anyway.
Meg, I'm very, very fond of you. I enjoy being with you.
But you're not making any promises.
How can I? And what would be the point?
None, I suppose. Well, I don't really want you to anyway.
What do you want?
I don't know.
Look, if you like,
We can finish it right here. I can walk out. We can just be friends.
Oh, very funny.
Well?
Delicious.
Come on. How am I supposed to get the key in the door?
Never mind the door.
What are the jeans still out?
I don't give a stuff about...
It's 2 a.m.
We've been burgled.
No.
Police have been. As far as I can see, all that's missing is $20 and a transistor radio.
Well, nothing else?
Well, it certainly wasn't professionals. The police think it was kids. Anyway, I've spent the last 2 hours cleaning the place up.
Hi, what's wrong?
I am about to do my block. Know what's just happened? You know Leanne Burke, you know, Nolene's daughter? Well, she came to visit her mother. Well, she was here yesterday, so I had to cut through a lot of red tape to get a visit approved because she said it was important. Well, there I was, standing there, when I suddenly overheard Leanne telling her mother about a burglary.
Oh, no, I'm trying to break that cycle.
Oh, hang on a second. Know what she told her mother was stolen?
No.
$20 and a transistor radio.
What?
That was my flat that kid broke into. Our flat! Sitting there, as bold as brass, telling her mother all about it all. It was quite bizarre.
Did you say anything?
What could I say? They deny it till the cars came home. But I'm going to tell the police.
Oh, I didn't expect you home so soon, Mrs. Jackson.
Apparently not.
Hey, it's just getting good.
And don't ever let me catch you smoking again.
Oh, fair go. Me mum lets me.
Well, I am not your mother. But as long as you're under my roof, you will do as I say. I am sick to death of coming home to a pigsty. As from now, young lady, you are going to learn to behave like a decent human being and respect other people's property. I mean, look at this room.
It's just like home.
On your feet, Leanne. Now, you are going to clean up this mess, and I am going to stand here and watch you do it. Understand?
Oh, nag. You're worse than me, Mum.
How's Karen? Well, you saw her the other day, didn't you?
Yes. Well, she's fine. What's that got to do with anything?
That's what I'd like to know.
Look, Meg, I know you don't like the idea, but it's only for a little while, and I do need the money.
You're lying, Greg. Now, look, I don't know why you changed your mind, and I'm not even sure I want to know. But it certainly wasn't for the money.
Meg.
No, not now. You think about it. If you want to talk, give me a ring.
So, how are things at Wentworth?
Oh, much the same.
Must be nice having Greg back. Although you can't count on him forever.
What do you mean?
All Karen meant was
I'm quite capable of speaking for myself, thank you.
What do you mean?
Greg, you can't expect me just to hang around whenever you need some comfort.
That's not the reason. My feelings for you haven't changed.
But your feelings for Karen have. And until you sort them out, I'd rather we didn't see each other.
Meg, it's not like that. Don't go.
Good night.
At least let me drive you home.
No, I'll get a taxi. Karen and I have at least one thing in common. Neither of us wants to play second fiddle. For here yet?
Just coming.
Where are the papers?
Over there.
Well, if it isn't dear old Meg Jackson.
It was me. I killed your husband.
But you're really glad to see me, eh?
The bastard.
Who? What's wrong?
Jim Fletcher. I've been set up. Here, you'll have to do the admissions. I'm sorry.
Meg, what's wrong?
Oh, it's nice to know you're welcome.
What kind of a twisted joke do you think this is?
What joke?
Did you know that Chrissy Latham was coming back in here?
I pointed it out to the governor. He said we're running a prison, not a kindergarten.
He said what?
He said if you had reservations, you could see him. Look, he's still upset about last night's meeting.
To hell with last night's meeting!
Get back to work, all of you!
He specifically asked for me to admit those prisoners?
Yes.
Me, by name?
Yes, but I'm sure it's nothing malicious. He's just up to his ears in work.
Look, stop trying to defend him, Vera. I am not going to work in this prison while she's here. And I am going to tell him right now. What the hell do you think you're playing at?
I beg your pardon.
Setting me up like that.
I haven't the faintest idea what you're talking about.
Oh, don't give me that.
I'm not giving you anything, Mrs. Jackson, and I want to know why you've come bursting in here like a maniac.
Chrissy Latham.
Who's Chrissy Latham?
Oh, my God. What are you, a half-wit? The new prisoner. Do you know what she did?
I haven't the faintest idea, but I'm sure we can talk about it.
She murdered my husband.
I didn't know. Miss Bennett didn't tell me.
She said you flew at her when she brought it up. Aren't you supposed to be the governor? Didn't you read their files?
Yeah, well, I haven't had time.
Haven't had time? New prisoners. It's your job to make time.
Look, Mrs. Jackson, I'm terribly sorry that this has happened. Now, if you'd care to sit down, I'm sure that we can discuss it.
The only thing I wish to discuss is when you are shipping that woman out, because I am not working while she's here.
Mrs.
Jackson to you, Mr. Fletcher.
Mrs. Jackson, we have a severe staff shortage. Now, you know that. I can certainly arrange for a minimum of contact.
Woman is transferred. I am not working here.
Well, there are procedures. They take time.
Mrs. Davidson would have gone straight to the department. That woman would not have been allowed through the gates. Now, I bailed you out of a hole last night, and I am not doing it again. This time, you can handle the job alone.
I was wondering how long it'd take you to try anything.
Why aren't you with the others?
Because I felt like lying down. I was having a nice dream, too. Want to hear it?
Not interested.
About a man named Bill. He used to work real hard, just so he didn't have to go home to his boring, sweet little wife. At least, that's the excuse he gave her.
Don't push me, Latham.
Oh, you should be over it by now, Mrs. Jackson. He's been dead a long time. Haven't you found yourself another bloke yet? No. No, I suppose you wouldn't have. Some women like to go through life mourning. Like the pity. Look at me. I'm lonely.
Yes, that's right. I'm an authority on it now. You made sure of that. But do you know what else you made me feel?
Hate.
I meant what I said the last time I saw you. It was you I was going to kill, not your husband. Why would I have wanted to hurt Bill? We had a real nice thing going for us. I figured if I got rid of you, I'd have done him a favor.
Liar!
He used to tell me he wanted a younger woman. Someone with a bit of fun. A bit of life. Oh. Come on, Mrs. Jackson. Let's show the governor a few bruises, eh? Oh, you'd love that, wouldn't you? Well, now let me tell you something. For as long as you're in this prison, if you ever mention Bill's name again, I'll make sure that every minute of every day will be as unpleasant as I can possibly make it for you.
You know I was born in prison. And like Sam, I was taken away when I was one too. But that was during the war. Well, I was sent to an orphanage. Things were much stricter in those days, and I didn't see my mother until she was released. By then I was six. It was too late for her. She wasn't fit to be a mother. Well, that's what they said. She used to visit me every Sunday. I used to live for those Sundays.
What happened to her?
Well, one day she just didn't arrive.
Found out 2 years later she died.
Oh, didn't they tell you?
Probably thought it was best I didn't know.
Haven't you ever had a home, Mrs. Jackson?
Well, by then I was 12. It was a bit late to be adopted.
Well, what about your dad?
He was killed in the war.
What are you doing in here?
I just brought some clean nappies.
Well, hurry up then.
Meg, is everything all right?
Oh, it's this letter. It's from Marty. Well, I was hoping that he's not coming home for Christmas. He's doing very well for himself. Seems I didn't do such a bad job after all. Just got to remember, he's growing up. Sometimes it's hard letting go.
It's better than holding on to them.
I didn't really have much choice, did I?
Damn good idea, don't you think, Mrs. J?
Well, it is difficult living alone, Doctor.
Oh, Megsy. Megsy. Oh, Megsy.
Hi, Jim.
Meg.
Mr. Fletcher.
Vera.
Jeff Butler. Won't you join us? Although, since there are ladies present, maybe we should move over there.
Meg, I don't think
We weren't intending to stay long.
Of course, but while you're here, you will have a drink with us.
Well, thanks.
Great. I take it Jimmy and your Miss Bennett don't see eye to eye. Ah, well, can't be helped. Still, it would have been nice to make it before someone go out for dinner.
Thanks for the thought, but really...
But what? I mean, there's no reason why we can't go out, is it?
Well, I came with Vera. I don't think I should desert her.
Oh, come on. I've just arrived in town. Now, surely you wouldn't begrudge a lonely old bachelor a few hours of your charming company?
I really appreciate the invitation, but I don't think I'll be much fun. I'm pretty tired and...
Sure. Look, no problem.
Thanks for the lift.
Pleasure.
Coming in for a minute?
Well, just for a minute. I won't stay.
Not even for a coffee?
Well, I shouldn't. I know you're tired, and I wouldn't want to wear out my welcome.
Oh, Leela's a wonderful cook, isn't she?
Hmm.
Well, sure you won't sit down?
Well, just for a moment.
Well, that's a definite no to coffee, then.
Well, I think it should be. Leela. I've always had a soft spot for the old girl.
Well, can I be rude and say it didn't seem mutual?
Oh, we're old sparring partners. It keeps us both on our toes.
Well, I was rather surprised to get an invitation.
Well... Actually, I asked Jim to invite you. I hope you don't mind.
Oh, not at all. Thanks for the thought.
Good. I'd really like to do it again sometime. Maybe dinner and a show or something like that?
Well, I'm pretty busy at the moment.
Every night? Look, if you'd prefer not to go, just say so. I understand.
Well, perhaps I could change some plans for Saturday, but I'd have to check it and phone you.
Oh, that'd be great.
Oh, okay then, Jeff. Well, I'll be in touch.
Good.
Thanks for this evening.
Pleasure.
Goodbye.
Night.
Hello, Meg Jackson.
Oh, it's Leela Fletcher here, Meg, Jim's wife.
Hello, Leela, how are you?
Look, just a word of warning in confidence between you and I. I believe you're going out with Jeff Butler next week. I'd be very careful about getting involved with him.
What do you mean?
He's just a little strange, that's all. Look, please don't tell Jim I phoned. He hates me interfering.
I suppose you're always out and about.
Oh, well, dinner, shows, the movies occasionally.
What sort of shows do you like?
Well, live shows mainly. Don't go in for plays much. Like cabaret, you know, whatever takes my fancy at the time.
I'd love to see that Cossack show. They really fascinate me, all that leaping and kicking.
Oh, the Russian show. Yeah, that's on tomorrow night, isn't it? Well, why don't I take you?
Well, you'd never get a ticket. They're always sold out.
If I can get the tickets, will you come?
Yes, but as I said...
Well, no buts. That's all settled. I'll pick you up at 7:30 tomorrow night.
Okay, wise guy. Right, well, I'm about to make a coffee. Would you like one?
It'll keep you awake.
Any objections?
Look, Lena, we're in chaos at the moment, so could you get to the point, please? What's Jeff got to do with the police?
The man's dangerous, Meg. What am I supposed to do? Close my eyes and hope it'll all work out? You won't believe me. Jim's too busy to do anything. Meg, it's very important that you listen to me.
Okay, I'll listen, but you'll have to be quick.
Well, you know Jeff went berserk in Sydney, and he nearly killed a man.
Yes, you told me.
Well, the other night he bashed up a man in the local pub. The man's in hospital.
Can't believe it.
You have to, it's true. Meg, I'm not telling tales because I enjoy it. I'm concerned about you. Meg, you there?
Oh, yes.
Look, the man's a maniac. He's going to go off the deep end at any minute. For heaven's sake, be careful.
Well, you've known him longer than I have. Well, I'll just do my best to discourage him.
No, don't do that. Oh, God knows what he might do. Just avoid him if you possibly can.
All right, then.
Hello, love. You look done in.
Oh, hello, Jeff.
I heard about the kerfuffle down at Wentworth. Front page news, eh?
Yes, I suppose it was.
I did ring and they said you were on the way home, so I thought I'd take you out to lunch. Put the roses back in your cheeks.
Oh, no, Jeff, I'm just too tired.
Well, you'll feel better after a good lunch.
No, thanks. I just want to curl up and die.
Well, what about if I go to a takeaway?
Look, I'm not hungry. I just want to sleep.
But you've got to eat.
Not today. Please, Jeff.
You're trying to brush me off?
No. Well, yes, maybe I am.
Well, you better have a good reason.
I just don't think it's going to work out.
Well, now, that doesn't sound like my girl, Meg. Now, why don't we just talk this thing over reasonably, shall we?
I want out, Jeff.
Well, that's a bit of a change of pace, isn't it?
I had time to think.
Has Leela had anything to do with your thinking?
No, it's got nothing to do with Leela. I've just got over one emotional disaster. I'm not prepared to try again.
Oh, crap!
Look, I can't take that risk.
Leela's really been getting to you, hasn't she?
I can make my own decisions.
And you've decided not to see me again. And you made the decision all on your own, right?
Yes.
Good. I just wanted to get things straight, that's all.
So, will you please go now?
No, I don't think I will. Sit down.
Now it's your turn to get something straight. Nobody, but nobody gives me the boot!
Do you understand, girl?
Meg. It was ringing. I'd better get over there. Ring the police.
So, if you want to be treated like a lady, you behave like one. Fair enough?
I said fair enough!
Yes.
Yes, that's the magic word. Now, a lady doesn't lead a bloke on and then dump him like a load of old garbage. She does what she's told, and she doesn't get hurt. Ah, good day there, fella. Come on in. Get an old mate a glass, Meg.
You all right?
She's all right.
Did you do that?
Well, you know how it is, mate. You've got to be firm with women and wogs.
Anything broken?
It's just bruises.
Don't worry, the police are on their way.
Oh, the police! Good old Leela's been at it again, eh?
I call the police.
Well, whatever for.
Come on, Meg.
Now, just where do you think you're going?
Out. Meg?
Sorry, fella.
You almost killed him. You're no better than he is, do you know that? Now just get out. Just get out and leave me alone.
even if you do find someone you like, well, there's always something wrong. They're either married or too set in their ways. What's funny? Meg? What's wrong? Did he do that?
He hurt me, dear. He really hurt me.
You wouldn't want to come and have dinner at my place tonight, would you?
Oh, no, sorry. I've got things to do at home.
Hello, Meg.
What are you doing here?
I have to see you. Can we talk?
Alone?
I think it would be better if I stayed, Mr. Butler.
Have we met?
Once in a hotel. I was with Meg.
I believe we'll be seeing one another in court in a couple of days.
What do you want?
Well, I guess I wanted to make a long overdue apology. I've been on bail and... well, I've had a lot of time to think, sort things out. I'd always been a fighting man and it just got to me. I wasn't myself, and I wanted you to know that.
If you're trying to make Meg change her testimony, I think the police would be interested.
Meg's always known what she's doing.
Most of the time.
I've really changed, you know.
You're too late. Excuse me.